Richard in the Old Oakey Workshop. Welcome to Garage Parking System, Perfect Parking Every Time, Method Number 2. Well, here's the genesis for Method 2. I was constructing Method 1 where the lines are underneath the ceiling, and my granddaughter said, "Well, Grandpa, why don't you just run the line up through the attic and have it come down over there where those tennis balls are?" Well, that ain't gonna work. So I dismissed that idea immediately, because if you connect the line to the top of the garage door, run it up into the ceiling like this, as the garage door goes up, it's going to pull the line, right? So it pulls the line, that's the opposite of what you want to do, so that's not going to work. So I'm actually constructing this bracket arm like this, and it's to raise the line from here up to here to get greater clearance above the floor, get it up near the ceiling. And I'm up on my ladder and I'm looking, I'm saying, wait a minute, look at this bar right here. Doesn't this bar and this shib right here go round and round and round and pull that cable up to raise the door? That gives me an idea. Maybe I could wrap a line around that and it could pay it out to let the tennis ball down, or wind it up to pull the tennis ball back up again. And that's the idea for Method 2. Well, it turns out that Method 2 is far simpler than Method 1. Because I don't have to do all that Pythagorean calculation and all those triangles to figure out where to attach the line. It's a much cleaner solution also, because the line goes directly into the attic and across and then directly out of the attic. And I don't have a line hanging down here that has obstructions in the way of its operation. So I just got to figure out how big that cylinder needs to be. So I counted the revolutions of that bar by sticking a tape on the end of it. I just watched the tape and how many times it went around as the door went up. Goes around seven and a half times, something like that. And I know that I want the tennis ball to be going up and down somewhere in the range of 40 to 45 inches. So that means that if it's 42 inches and the bar goes around seven times, then I need the cylinder to wind up 6 inches of line every time it goes around. So the circumference of the cylinder has got to be 6 inches. And we can figure out the diameter, therefore, by using the fact that the circumference is equal to pi times the diameter. So the diameter is equal to the circumference, which I want to be, which is 6 inches. Divide that by pi, I get about 2. So I want to start off with a 2-inch diameter cylinder. Now, the bar is 1 inch in diameter, so to make it 2 inches in diameter, I'll add a half an inch all the way around. And I did that by simply cutting some strips of half inch plywood, and I put those in there. You can see them in the middle of the cylinder. Those are half inch plywood strips. They happen to be a half inch wide as well. So I put them around there. Turns out that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them fit on there. And then all I needed to do was build those up, which I did with some cardboard. So I built them up with pieces of cardboard, layer after layer. I fine-tuned the system to get it right. And then I put a couple of hose clamps on the end, because that thing has started to slip on me. So there's actually some non-stick tape that's on those wood pieces, trying to keep them from slipping on the bar. And if you look real close in there, you can see a little mark on one of the pieces of wood and on that piece of tape. So I can tell if that thing has slipped on me, which it has not done since I did the retrofit and made it better. So that's really all there is to it. So there you go. That's all there is to Method 2. Simple compared to Method 1. Not as simple as method zero, right? That's pretty easy, but the balls are in the way all the time. So I just ran the line directly from those cylinders up into the attic. I just punched a little hole in the sheetrock, actually, routed the line right underneath the underside of the roof with screw eyes, brought it over to a place near where the tennis ball is going to be down below, brought that line then down through a piece of 3/4 inch rigid electrical conduit, and so got it down there and then down through the attic through about 12 inches insulation between the floor of the attic and the sheetrock of the ceiling. So I had to get it through that and down a hole, and then there it is. So it's a lot easier, not easier than method zero, but it's easier than method one. All the details are at olokiworkshop.com, so you can take a look there. Thanks for watching. See you next time.